Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. So in today's video, we'll be discussing few numericals from the topic of projectile motion. But this explanation will be concept based, means I'll be explaining the concept also. Okay, so I have selected the questions from NCERT and few from concept of physics. Okay, so first question is from NCERT, chapter is motion in plane. So the question is question number 4.15. The ceiling of a long hall is 25 meter high. What is the maximum horizontal distance that a ball thrown with a speed of 40 meter per second can go without hitting the ceiling of the hall? Okay. So suppose this is the floor and this is the ceiling. Okay. And it is given that what is the maximum horizontal distance that the ball thrown with a speed of 40 meter per second can go. Now it is given that the ceiling is 25 meter high. Okay, so this height is 25 meter. Okay, and so the ball has to go like this so that it doesn't hit the ceiling, and at the same time travels the maximum range. Okay, means for that height, for this height, what range it will travel? This is the question. Okay. Now, what is given is, see, velocity of projection is given. Okay. So, velocity of projection is u, it is 40 meter per second. That is the velocity of projection. So, with this velocity of projection, you have this height. Okay. So, from that information, we can calculate the value of this angle. Because what is the formula for height? Height is u square sine square theta by twice g. This is the formula for height. Okay. So height is 25 meter. So 25 is equal to u square 40 square sine square theta by 2g. So g will take as 10. Okay. G is 9.8 meter per second square, but we can approximate it to be 10 meter per second square. That is the acceleration due to gravity. So from this we can calculate the get the value of sine square theta as 25 into 20 divided by 40 into 40 square. Okay, so this is 2 times, this is 5, this is 8, so this is 5 by, so this is sine square theta is equal to 5 by 16. Okay, so sine theta is equal to square root of 5 by 16. Okay, so from this we can get the value of theta as sine inverse root 5 by 16. Okay, now if you use calculator or if you use the trigonometric table to get the value of this theta, so this value comes to be around 33.3 degree. So now we have information about this angle theta, and now we want the value of range. So what is the formula for range? R is equal to u square sine 2 theta by g. Okay, u is 40 meter per second. So R is equal to 40 square sine 2 times 33.3 degree divided by 10. Okay, so if you simplify this, you will get R is equal to 150 meter. Okay, so this is the final answer. So here the main idea is, see, height is fixed because the ball should not hit the ceiling. So the height is fixed. So since the height is fixed, so that means angle of projection is also fixed, because the ball can attain a maximum height of 25 meter. So angle of projection we can calculate from the information from height. Now once angle of projection is known, velocity of projection is also already given, so we can calculate the range. Okay. Now question number 4.16 is similar to the previous question. Here it is given that a cricketer can throw a ball to a maximum horizontal distance of 100 meter. How much high above the ground can the cricketer throw the same ball? Okay, so first information is cricketer can throw the ball to a maximum horizontal distance. Now maximum horizontal distance. This also means maximum range, R max, and it is given to be 100 meter. It is given to be 100 meter. Okay, acha. Now range, we know that R is equal to u square sine 2 theta by g. Now range is maximum for theta is equal to 45 degree, and range maximum, it is equal to, if you substitute this value over here, so this becomes 1. Means for sine 2 theta is equal to 1, range is maximum. So that is u square by g. This is maximum range. Now this is equal to 100 meter. So this is equal to 100 meter. Okay. And what we have to find, how much high above the ground can the cricketer throw the same ball? Okay. So from this, u square will be 100 into 10. So u is equal to 10 root 10 meter per second. Okay. How much high he will be able to throw? So that is obviously in the vertical direction. In the vertical direction, he can throw in the maximum height. Okay. So h is equal to u square by twice g. This is the formula for vertical height, maximum height. See, you don't have to remember this formula separately. Okay. See, we have this h equal to u square sine square theta by yg. So this is the formula for maximum height when for oblique projection, that is when velocity is u, angle is theta, it goes like this. So this is the height, maximum height. Okay. Now when it is projectile is projected in the vertically upward direction, so this projectile will go like this. So this angle will become 90 degree. So this theta will become 90 degree. So sine square 90 degree is 1. So this term will become 1. So height will become u square by 2g. Okay. So this we need to find. So u is 10 root 10. So h will be equal to 10 root 10 square divided by 2g. Okay. 10 root 10 means this quantity. So 1000 divided by 2 into 10. So this is equal to 50 meter. So the cricketer will be able to throw the same ball to a maximum height of 50 meter. Next, let us solve questions from concept of physics. This is question number 23. A ball is projected vertically upward with a speed of 50 meter per second. Find the maximum height, time to reach the maximum height, the speed at half the maximum height. Okay. So the ball is projected like this, vertically upward direction with speed u. Okay. And this speed is given to be equal to 50 meter per second. 50 meter per second. So it will go like this, it will come down. So this is a case of vertical projection. Vertical projection. Okay. So the first question is, you have to find maximum height. So maximum height, maximum height is h is equal to u square by 2g for vertical projection. Okay. So u square is, u is 50. So 50 into 50 divided by 2 into 10. So this this is 25. So this is equal to 125 meter. Okay. So this will be the maximum height. Acha. Next, they have asked time to reach the maximum height. That is time of ascent. Time of ascent. Okay. See, total time of flight is 2u by g. This is the total time of flight. Now it is equal to time of ascent plus time of descent. And time of ascent is equal to time of descent. So that is equal to u by g plus u by g. So this time of ascent, this time of descent. So that means we have to find the value of this expression u by g. So time of ascent is t is equal to u by g. What is u? U is 50 meter. Okay. This is 50 meter. So 50 divided by 10. So that is equal to 5 second. Okay. Now third part is speed at half the maximum height. Okay. Speed at half the maximum height. So see, maximum height is 125 meter. So half the maximum height is 125 by 2. So initial speed is u is equal to 50 meter per second. So this is half the maximum height. So this is h by 2. So here the velocity is v. we have to find this expression v. Okay, so for this part of the journey, if we use the equation v square minus u square is equal to twice a s. Okay, so v square minus 50 square is equal to 2 minus g, h is 125 by 2. Okay, so simplifying this, we have v square minus 2500 is equal to, this g is 10 minus 10, so this is minus 1250. Okay, so this is v square is equal to 1250, so v is equal to 35 meter per second. Okay, so velocity at this point, half the maximum height will be 35 meter per second. So next question is a very interesting question. Question number 24 from Concept of Physics. A ball is dropped from a balloon going up at a speed of 7 meter per second. If the balloon was at height 60 meter at the time of dropping the ball, how long will the ball take in reaching the ground? Okay. Now see, suppose this is some height h, okay, and from this point, if something is dropped, we take its initial velocity equal to 0, okay, because suppose this is a top of a building, this is top of a building of height h. Now from this height, you are dropping something, that means initially the object was at rest, okay. Now that is the simple concept. If something is dropped from a height, we take the initial velocity to be 0. But here we have a different case. So this is, suppose this is a balloon. Okay, this is the red basket. This hot air balloon is going upward. So it is going upwards with some velocity u that is given. Now from here, something is dropped. Okay. Now, if we take the downward direction as positive and the upward direction as negative, okay. See, this is just a convention you can take. You can take the upward direction as positive and downward direction as negative also. Because, but here we are going to study the journey in the downward direction. So that is why I am taking it to be downward direction as positive. Okay. So here see, this point, see, I am at rest and I am dropping something. Initial velocity is 0. But if I am moving in the upward direction, so this object is also having, at the instant of dropping, this object is having a velocity in the upward direction. Though it will come down, but at the instant of dropping, it is dropped from this balloon which is rising upward. Okay, so at the instant of dropping, it is having a velocity in the upward direction. So that means here, initial velocity will not be 0. In this case, the initial velocity will not be equal to 0 and it will be negative because it is in the upward direction. Okay, so what is this height? So what are the data that is given here? Ball is dropped from a balloon going up at a speed of 7 meter per second. Okay, so this is balloon 7 meter per second. And if the balloon was at height 60 meter, so this is 60 meter. This is 60 meter. Okay, how long will the ball take in reaching the ground? Okay, so we have to find the information about t. Okay, obviously it is falling under gravity, so we have information about acceleration. Okay, so see, in the question, what are things given? Velocity is given. This is displacement, obviously, displacement. Time we need to find. Acceleration we know is g. So s, u, t, a. Now if you see these terms, you will have this equation in mind. S equal to ut plus half at square, isn't it? S u t a, correct? Acha. So s is how much? 60 meter. This velocity, see, it is coming in the downward direction, so we are measuring distance from this point. This is 0 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, 60. So downward direction is taken as positive, so s is 60. Upward direction, this balloon is going in the upward direction, so object at the instant of dropping, it is having a velocity in the upward direction. So it is minus 7 into t plus half 10. Again, acceleration it is in the downward direction. Downward direction we are taking it as positive. So plus 10 into t square. Okay, so this is 5t square. So this becomes 5t square minus 7t minus 6t is equal to 0. Okay, so this is a quadratic equation, and by solving this we can get the value of t. Now this can be simplified as t is equal to minus b, so minus 7 plus minus b square, so minus 7 square, b square minus 4 is c, so minus 4 into 5 into minus 6t divided by twice a, so 2 times 5. Okay, so this is t is equal to 7 plus minus square root of 49 plus 4 5 is 20, 1200 divided by 10. So now here we have to consider only the positive roots. So if you simplify this, you will get this to be equal to 4.2 second. So in 4.2 second, this object will reach the ground. Okay. So here the main concept is, see this velocity, it is negative because it is taken from a rising balloon. Okay. So for such cases, you have to take the sign convention, okay, properly. So next is question number 25. A stone is thrown vertically upward with a speed of 28 meter per second. Find the maximum height reached by the stone. Find its velocity 1 second before it reaches the maximum height. Okay, so the stone is thrown vertically upward with a velocity u is equal to 28 meter per second. So it goes like this and then comes down. Okay. So find the maximum height reached by the stone. So maximum height h is equal to u square by twice g. So that is 28 square divided by twice g. So g is say 9.8, or you can take it as to be 10 also. Okay. So if you simplify, this is something around 392 meters. So this is the maximum height. Okay. So second part is find its velocity 1 second before it reaches the maximum height. So for that we have to find first how much time it takes to reach the maximum height. Okay. So t is equal to u by g. So that is 28 divided by g 9.8. So this is approximately 2.85 second. Okay. 2.85 second. So find its velocity 1 second before it reaches the maximum height. So that means, what is the velocity at time t is equal to 1.85 second? So it is somewhere here. Highest point velocity is 0. So here, what is the velocity? Initial velocity is known. We need to find this velocity. Time is known. So we have to use the equation v is equal to u plus at. So v is how much? V is to be determined. What is u? 28 minus 9.8 into 1.85. Okay, so on simplifying we get v is equal to 9.8 meter per second. Okay, now part C is quite interesting. Does the answer of the part B changes if the initial speed is more than 28 meter per second, such as 40 meter per second or 80 meter per second? Means if this initial velocity is more than 28 meter per second, will this answer change? Okay, so the answer is this answer is not going to change. Why? Because see, after projection, it is having a constant acceleration. A is equal to 9.8 meter per second square. Means while going, it is constant retardation, and while coming down, constant acceleration. So since, what is acceleration? Acceleration is rate of change in velocity. So rate of change in velocity is not changing, it is constant. The rate at which the velocity is changing, it is constant. So that means this, see, at this point velocity is 9.8 meter per second. At this point, how much time this takes? From this point, it takes time 1 second. So time is fixed, final velocity is fixed. So this velocity will also be fixed. It is not going to change. Why? Because acceleration is uniform. Okay. So this concept is very important.